Welcome to online course on Introduction to R Programming. Our today's lecture 5 is on basics of calculations, R as calculator. The previous lecture we discussed R as calculator, then with additional operations we will see, then built-in functions and some assignments. Coming to outline, first we will see R as calculator. Here we will discuss integer division operation, then modulo division operation. These two comes as part of R as calculator. Then we will see built-in functions. What are the various built-in functions available in R software? What are their syntaxes, how to execute them? With examples we will demonstrate. Then assignments. So how the values are assigned? What are the various ways of assigning values to the variables? That can be discussed under assignments, assignment operators. Then finally, concluding remarks with tips. Now we will see the first one, integer division. This operation is denoted by the symbol percentage divide percentage. So in between the operands values, you can use this symbol. Then the result is integer division. So what is integer division? First of all, division in which the fractional part, that is a remainder, is discarded. So excluding the remainder, now it takes the quotient value, that is integer division. So for example, earlier whatever we computed with vectors, addition, multiplication, division, subtraction, power, similar fashion we will compute the integer division also, but use this symbol percentage divide percentage. So we have two vectors here, C of 2 comma 3 comma 5 comma 7 with integer division of another vector C of 2 comma 3. The order of taking the calculation is same earlier whatever we discussed. The output calculations will be like this. You can see first it takes two integer division of 2, the first value in the left side vector to the first value in the right side vector. Then 3, second one with second one, 3 integer division with 3, 2, 3 are over. Then you can take 5, 7 combination, 5 integer division with 2, then 7 integer division with 3. So here it won't consider remainders. So it takes the quotient values. Now you can see here 2 by 2. 2 by 2, its remainder is 0, but here remainder is not considered. So 2 by 2, what is the value? 1. So then 3 by 3, 3 by 3. So its remainder is 0. Now the value is 1. So 5 by 2, so 2 twos. So 2 twos, so that quotient value only it takes, but remainder is 1, it won't take remainder. 7 by 3, so 3 twos, 6. So the quotient value is 2, but remainder is 1, it won't consider remainder. So like that, in the integer division, the fractional part remainder is discarded. Now we can execute this command in our R software. So C of 2, 3, 5, 7, integer division. The symbol is percentage slash percentage C of, here what the user again, 2, 3, whatever you can take, how you can see. So 2 by 2, so 2 ones, the quotient is 1. Then 3 by 3, so 3 ones, the quotient is 1. Then 5 by 2, 2 twos, the quotient is 2. then 7 by 3, 3 2s, the quotient is 2. So this is the output of integer division. This is the symbol, so we have to use. Similarly, next one, modulo division operation. So the general form of modulo operation is x mod y. But here the symbol, in place of mod, we use double percentage symbol. So for integer division, percentage slash percentage. Whereas modulo division, both symbols are percentages. So x mod y. Here modulo operation finds the remainder after division of one number by another. So here it takes the remainders. Whereas integer division, the remainders are discarded. But modulo division, it takes the remainders. For example, here you can see C of 2, 3, 5, 7. Modulo 2. So how this can be computed? 2 modulo 2, the first value with 2. So here only one value. So all you can take modulo with the right side, one value. Then 3 modulo 2, 5 modulo 2, 7 modulo 2. So here remainders you can take 2 by 2. So what is the remainder? 0. Then 3 by 2, what is the remainder? 1. Then 5 by 2, what is the remainder? 1. 2 2's 4, then remainder is 1. Then 7 by 2. So sorry, it is here 7 by 2. So 2, 3 is 6, remainder is 1. Now this is the output here. Now you can try to execute this one. So the same C of 2, 3, 5, 7 modulo division with only constant 2. Then it takes every time mod 2 with left side vector. So it displays only the remainder values. Even you can try this one also with modulo. So now it takes 2 modulo 2, 3 modulo 3, then 5 modulo 2, 7 modulo 3. See the result. Even with vector combination also. So like that, modulo division will be computed. Yeah, this one, what we seen just now, with two vectors, modulo operation. Even if the right side, the length is not matching with left side splits, again here, you will get error. Like that, we will compute modulo division operation. Then coming to built-in functions. R supports many built-in functions. So using these functions directly, you can compute the values. The following table shows various frequently used functions with their description. So in the left side, whatever the name is mentioned, the same syntax we have to use in R software. The first one is max with brackets. So within bracket, you can use the values, possible values, inputs. So what is this one? Maximum value. Then min. What is this one? Minimum value. Sum. It takes the sum value, sum of the given inputs. Then prod, product value. Then abs, absolute value. Then sqrt, square root value. Then exp, exponential function. Then round, floor, ceiling. Round means rounding, floor means up value, ceiling means down values. Then log, then log 10, then log 2. These are all logarithmic functions. Then some more. Sine, cos, tan, a sine, a cos, a tan. These are all trigonometric functions. Then sine h, cos h, tan h, a sine h, a cos h, a tan h. Hyperbolic functions. These are all frequently used functions in R software. Now we will see one by one execution with examples. The syntaxes are same, whatever the names listed here, same names you have to follow. Now the first one, maximum. So it is denoted by max. Within brackets, you can give the values, any values you can give. Then it takes the maximum of the given inputs. Here max of 1.2 comma 3.4 comma minus 7.8. Out of these three, which is highest value? So minus value is the least value. So positive 1.2, 3.4. Out of these, maximum is 3.4. The output is 3.4. Same function you can use by using C also combined. So max of C of the three values, which gives the same result. Now you can execute this function using our R software. First, you can clear the previous history. So max of 1.2 comma 3.4 comma minus 5, whatever the value. Now you can see. So the maximum is 3.4. Same we can use using C command. C of. So within bracket, max is function within bracket. C of, you are combining multiple values in the vector. From the vector, it displays the maximum value. Similarly, now you can see the second function, minimum. The syntax is min of number 1, comma number 2, comma number 3, and so on. So here least value, negative value is the least, so it takes least. Same we can use min of C of. So the result is same. Now you can execute this minimum function. You can see same the first one. You can edit minimum of 4. So minimum of 1.2, 3.4 and minus 5. What is the lowest value? Minus 5 is the result. Same we can use with combine C of. So that C of you can use within the brackets of minimum. So output is same. So minus 5. So that is minimum function. Then coming to square root. Square root function is denoted as SQRT. So square root of a single value you can give. Then it gives the result of square root of that value. Or by using vector, all values you want to take square root, you can use C of. SQRT of, here can say C of 4, 9, 16, 25. For each value in the vector, it takes square root. Square root of 4, 2. Square root of 9, 3. Square root of 16, 4. Square root of 25, 5. Whereas the first example, single value. Square root of 4, so it takes 2. So like that, we can execute a square root function. Now you can see these demonstrations. First, we will see square root of 4. So it gives 2 as the result. Then multiple values using vector, square root of C of, suppose 4 comma 9 comma 16 comma 25. Close the C of function. Now you can see how the output is computed. Square root of 4 is 2, square root of 9 is 3, square root of 16 is 4, square root of 25 is 5. Each and every value in the vector, it takes a square root. Like that, the square root is computed. Then coming to other functions, how to calculate sum. So here sum, the syntax is SUM within brackets. Directly you can give the numerical values, sum of 2, 3, 5, 7, separated by comma. Then it adds all the values in this function, or using C also. Anyone you can use, but both gives the same result. Only numerical values can be added. Now you can execute this one. First, I am giving sum of 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So the total sum is 10. Same you can use by using C of, combining in the form of vector. which gives the same result. That is sum function. Then coming to product, second one, PROD is the syntax. Here also same PROD of the input values you can give. Then it multiplies 2 into 3 into 5 into 7. Then product of C of, again same using vector, it takes the same result. So now PROD of, now I am multiplying 1, 2, 3, 4. The result is 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. So this is the result, 24. Same you can use with combined function as a vector C of. Now you can see the result is same, there is no change. That is product function. Then coming to round function, rounding of the value. The syntax is ROND within bracket. You can give the numerical value with the decimals or without decimals. So here round of 1.23, it gives the current value only one. Then if you can give above 0.5, so 1.83, then it gives the next rounded value two. So this is the output, the right side window. Now you can execute this one. So round of 1.23. So it is less than, after decimal it is less than 5, so it gives the 1 only. If you can give after decimal it is greater than 5, suppose you can give 6.5 and above, whatever, so it takes the next highest value. So that is round function. Then coming to next, floor and ceiling values, up and down values. So the syntax is FLOOR within brackets, give the value. Suppose floor of 1.23, it gives 1 only. Even floor of 1.83, it gives 1 only. Whereas ceiling, it gives the highest value. So ceiling of 1 point something, whatever, it gives the next value. 1.23 to 1.83 also 2. Here you can observe the differences between round, floor and ceiling values. Now you can execute these commands. Floor of 1.23, floor of 1.8. So whatever, it gives the same value. Whereas ceiling, CILING, so 1.1, anything after decimal, so it is rounded to next value. CILING, ceiling of some 1.7. So it gives the next highest value. So that is floor and ceiling functions demonstration. Then coming to some other functions. So all you can type as it is, whatever the syntax is given here. So the outputs are displayed here. First, ABS of minus one absolute, then logarithmic function with base 2, with base 10, then exponent. So all you can practice here. So one by one, the output is shown here. Here you can see. We'll also lively demonstrate first absolute. So absolute of any negative value, it gives the positive value. So minus one, that is one. Then absolute of any positive value, no change, same only it gives. Next, log value without any base, log 1, so 0. Then log 0, so infinite. Then similarly, log with base 10, log 10 of 1, 0. Log 10 of 0, infinite. Similarly, log 2 of 0, infinite. Log 2 of 1, 0. So these are all three types of logarithmic functions. Next one, you can see exponent. So exponent of 1, this is 2.71. Exponent of 0, that is 1. Exponent of 2, that is 7.33, like that. So this is exponent function. These are all the outputs. Then some more trigonometric functions. So directly you can execute these commands, you will get the results. So here we have normal trigonometric functions, then hyperbolic trigonometric functions. First, take sine of 0, sine function 1, then sine of 1. You can calculate with your calculator also, whether it is giving same result or not. Then cos of 0, then cos of 1, then tan of 0, then tan of 1, then a sine of 0, then a sine of 1. So all you can execute, then this one, then a cos of 0. This is one, the result, a cos of 1. This is the result, then a tan of 0. The 0, a tan of 1. Tan of 1. So these are all trigonometric functions. See, here the output is pasted here. Similarly, you can practice it. Similarly, hyperbolic trigonometric functions, we'll test it here. Same with the hyperbolic. So then sine h of 0, hyperbolic, sine h of 1. Similarly, cos h of 0, then cos h of 1. Then similarly, tan h of 0, this is 0. Then tan h of 1, this is 0.76. Similarly, next, using a cos, a sin, a tan with hyperbolic, a sin h of 0, 0, a sin h of 1, 0.82, a cos cos h of 0. See, warning, so nothing will be displayed, null. Then a cos h of 1, hyperbolic value 0. Then a tan h of 0, 0, a tan h of 1, it shows infinity. So these are all hyperbolic functions. All you can try with the different values and you can practice it. Those are all built-in functions available in R. Then coming to assignments. Assignments can be made in two ways. We already seen these concepts in the earlier lectures. So our previous lecture, we already discussed the assignment operators are two ways. One is left arrow with dash. Another one, equal sign. The left side you can observe. X left arrow with dash 6. What is the meaning of this? 6 is assigned to the variable X. And whenever you can call X, 6 is displayed. Then if you want to know what is the type of X, for that we will use one function, mode. This is also an inbuilt function. So mode of X, if we can give like this, what X contains? Numeric value. So it displays the type as numeric. For example, another one, this is another way of representing assignment. Equal symbol, X equal to 8, then you can call X, what it shows? 8. Mode of X is, what 8 is? Numeric value. You can try to demonstrate the same. First way is X left arrow with dash, I am taking 10. Now enter X, it shows 10. And if you want to know mode of X, that is numeric. Why? Because it contains numerical value. Then another way, I am using x equal to 20. Here the symbol, I am using equal symbol. Then call x 20. Then what is mod of x? Again, it is numeric. Similarly, you can assign character values also. The right side you can see. So first we'll assign single character using single quotes, x equal to within single quote a. Then you can call a is displayed. What is mod of x? Character. Then you can use string also. So using double quotes, suppose hello within double quotes, then x displays the same string, mod of x is same character, string consisting of characters. I can demonstrate this one. Now I am using x equal to within single quote a, then call x, x is a. Then you can test mod of x. Now it takes only recent value of x, that is character. Now I am taking another one. So within double quotes, take the string. If it is character, only single quote. So within double quotes, welcome to R. Now what x contains? Welcome to R. Then what is mode of x? So character. So you can assign numeric values as well as character values to the variable, but single character within single quote. Then multiple character means we can't separate it by comma. At that time we use combined vector c of. Suppose here you can see x less than c of a comma b comma c. Suppose a b c d I am storing into x in the form of a vector. Now you can call x. So a b c d not displayed. Even strings also, but use double quotes. So here double quotes, hi, that is one string. Then second string you can type something, hi, hello. Suppose two strings I have taken. Now call x. So hi, hello, whatever, same thing will be displayed. Then mode of x, so characters only it contains, using combined function. So we can store multiple characters into a variable or multiple strings into a variable, or without using command, only single character, a single string can be assigned to the variable. These are all two ways of representing assignments. Now see the demonstration, what we seen. The sample screenshot is displayed here. That is representation of assignments in R software. Then one more concept, an assignment can also be used to save values in variables. That this point we already covered. Every lecture we are discussing this. R is case sensitive. That means capital X is not same as small x. So for example, here an assignment can also be used to save values in variables. For example, here I am storing 1, 2, 3, 4 into x1. Then the result of x1 power 2 is stored in x2. Now you can execute this one. So x1 equal to c of 1, 2, 3, 4. Clear the window. X1 equal to c of 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what x1 contains? 2, 3, 4. Now you are storing x2 equal to x1 power 2. That means in x1, whatever the values, taking power of each and every value, that is 1 power 2 2 power 2, 3 power 2, 4 power 2. What is the result now? What x2 contains? 1 power 2, 1. 2 power 2, 4, 1, 4. 3 power 3, 9. 4 power 2, 16. Now you can see 1, 4, 9, 16. This is the output. So the result can be stored into another variable. Computation. This concept also already covered in previous lectures. So that's all about the basics of calculations in R. First, R as calculator. Here we discussed about integer division and modulo division. Then after that, we discussed built-in functions, various functions, their syntaxes with examples of demonstrations. Then assignment operators, two ways are there to represent assignment operators. One is the left arrow with the dash symbol, another one equal symbol. Now coming to concluding remarks, here I would like to request all of you that you please try to practice all the assignments, taking different types of examples, and whatever examples I have taken, try to take some other values, then try to make them more complicated. Then try to take some questions from the assignment or some questions from, say, other books, and try to practice it. So you can go through the week one assignment. In that, some of the questions based on our lecture 5 and lecture 4, simply you can take those expressions and you can copy in the R console window, then see the output. Like that, you can answer the assignment. So all of you complete our first assignment. But till now, the week one module, all 5 lectures are completed. Now you can parallelly complete the assignment one by following these 5 lectures. The assignment is majorly based on the lectures 4 and 5. So next we will move to our week 2 module. Till then, goodbye. All of you, happy learning.